Thank you. na ibu tupu nke ibu ikuzirela anyị eziokwu gị dịka onye na-anya aka ibipụta ya na ndụ anyị site na kristi onye nwanyị onye nwanyị na onye ụlọ Anyị na-ekele gị n'ihi kwere ka anyị dị mma ịkwụ n'ihu dị na-efe gị. Anyị dị mma arịọ ka anyị bụ ndị na-anata ha ọbara nke Kristi bụrụ otu site na nchekwa nke Mmụọ Nsọ. Nna, cheta nzukọ gị gaa zuru ụwa niile, mee ka ihu na ya gijupụta ya, gọzie Pope anyị bụ Francis na ndị Bishọp anyị bụ Charles na Christian na ndị ofe ọtọ gị niile. Chetakwa ụmụnna anyị ndị Juu kwe were gaa n'ezumike nke ọrụ. Gbabata ha na ndị ọzọ niile nwụrụ anwụ n'ihe nke mgbe gị, biko mere anyị niile ebere. Ka anyị chọrọ ozi Maria dị ngọzi na-eke Chukwu na ndị apọsụlụ na ndị nsọ gị niile, ndị mere uche gị n'ụwa were keta ndụ ebe ebe. Ka anyị chọrọ kwa ha na-eto gị na-edu gị ebube site na Jesu Kristi ọnwa gị. Ihe niile kere eke na-eso ya bụ Kristi, na-esikwa n'ime ya n'aka ya, na-edikọrọ otu nke Mmụọ Nsọ, na-enye gị bụ Chukwu Nna ike niile, nsọpụrụ na otuto niile, site n'ụwa tụwa niile.
Thank you. Let us pray.
Mr. KK is in the Catholic, the wife may be,
But there are strong supporters of this community and all the churches.
So it's good to have people like that with us. We're going to have a parish meeting at the end of our socials. So please, we should, after eating and drinking, we should sit back the parish members for a brief parish meeting. Next Sunday, that's the next month, is going to be Mother's Day. And the women, the Igbo women in Ottawa, are all coming here to celebrate Mother's Day with us. So we are inviting everybody that is here to come celebrate Mother's Day with us. Next Sunday, there's going to be a lot of, you know, the mothers are going to come out in their full regalia and with all the food and all the stuff, you know. So you are invited to join us next Sunday. Next month, that's the end of May for Mother's Day. And there are plans, you know, afoot to have a novelty match between the mothers and the fathers sometime in June after Father's Day. Our mothers, they say they want to, you know, they want to deal with the fathers. So we're hoping that in June we see who is better. So please, thank you so much for coming again. And please, Rossi, downstairs in the parish hall. Thank you.
So before we give the final blessing, I want to make this special announcement here in the church, because I know we are all hungry, eh? After praying for almost 2.5 hours, we must be hungry. And since we may not have the time in the hall to make other announcements, I want to make this important announcement here in the church. It has to do with pro-life as well. And this is a great forum to do that, since we are having a pro-life mass. And it's about the March for Life coming up next month. On the 12th of May, it's the biggest rally, you know, the biggest rally we have in Canada, you know, whereby we all come together to bear witness to life and say no to all abuse that are related towards life, from conception to natural death. And this year's event is going to be really special, more so for us Nigerians and Igbos, so to say. I don't know how many of you have heard about or know Uju Ekocha. Uju Ekocha. Okay. She's a woman activist, a pro-lifer, whatever. And she's an Igbo girl from Mbise in Igbo State, Nigeria. And then she's based in England, in UK. Uju is the founder and president of Culture of Life Africa. She has written in several articles, including the widely read open letter to Melinda Gates. So the Liberal government has stated it will fund abortion internationally through the Maternal Newborn Child Health Initiative. And so, Uju will speak on why this is a death sentence for Africa and why your tax dollars should not fund abortion overseas. I was just watching one of his video clips the other day, and she beautifully answered a lady from Denmark who was saying that because Uju had already given a talk, that for the Western world, you know, to impose abortion on Africa or any form of disrespect for life is anti-African, is anti our culture and our tradition, is in fact neo-colonization. And then she said that in our African context and understanding, the idea of abortion has nothing good in it. It's bad. It's a direct attack on life. And it's against our culture, it's against our philosophies, against our way of thinking. But then, surreptitiously, the Western society is trying to impose this whole idea, trying to brainwash and colonize Africa. So this is going to be the main theme of her paper in Ottawa. So she's coming to Ottawa Life on the 12th of May, after the March for Life on the Parliament Hill. There will be a roast dinner. The dinner is open to all, but then you have to buy the ticket ahead of time. The ticket costs $80. Early bird, okay? $80. And then you purchase it after 31st of April for $90. So $10 is worth something, right? So we have these posters everywhere in the basement and all across the city. So if you want to buy the ticket, the numbers to call there and all that information that you may need to contact get your own ticket. So I invite all of us, even if we can't afford to be at the Rose dinner that evening, to come to Parliament Hill, you know, to be part of this movement, okay, to be on the side of life. It is, like I said, the biggest gathering, the biggest rally in Ottawa, and let us be part of it as Christians, as Catholics, as Africans, as Ndi Igbo. So please pass the word around, and we hope to see you on the hill, and then also at the dinner on 12th of May. Thank you. God bless.